हेलो हेलो हेलो, वेलकम एवरीवन टू दिस डॉजी इंटरनेशनल 2.0 क्वार्टर फाइनल्स। अनीश गिरी वर्सेस ग्रैंडेलियस निल्स एंड विदित गुजराती वर्सेस डेविड हॉवेल। वेल, वी आर इन द मिडल ऑफ द सुपर हीरोज कप एंड दैट्स द रीजन व्हाई वी आर अ बिट लेट, बट वी आर इन टाइम फॉर द पार्टी। इट इज टू एंड हाफ इन द मैच ऑफ अनीश गिरी वर्सेस निल्स ग्रैंडेलियस राइट नाउ। Anish here playing with the black pieces has a very comfortable position. On the other hand, Vidit Gujarati is in some bit of trouble. As you can see here, he has a better position against Howell, but he is 2 points down in the match. Chat, please correct me if I am wrong, if I have made any mistakes in the scoring, because it's quite possible in my hurry to, you know, set this up. Anish is 3.5, 1.5. Okay, thank you. That's what I said. Yeah, I was very quick in trying to set everything up. I was figuring out, but okay. So 3.5. Anything else? Anish is 3.5. Okay. Cool. Anish's score is 3.5 and we are all set. Guys, Vidit Gujarati is a pawn up right now. Okay. His time is ticking down, but his position looks pretty good. I'm going to eat also, guys, along with this. I don't know why Vidit is thinking so much. Is it because... what's happening? Why is he not moving? Am I missing something? Maybe I have to refresh, guys. Now it's working or what? Okay. Working. What about this? Working here as well. Okay, good. We are all set. Sorry for that. So Anish has a good position. He's leading in the match. He's already better. And Vidit also doing well. Guys, look at this. The knight can jump to d3 at the right moment. Also, queen b1 pinning here. I'm just wondering if the moves are being made or not, Amruta. Here. Lee chess is lagging today. Where else can we watch? So if Lee chess is lagging, play chess is not covering it. Maybe we can go to chess 24 and try to see if we can see from there, pick up their live viewer. Because they would have the right times and everything. Okay. So yeah, this game here is Anish. Let me fix it. Yeah, I think the main thing is the time, guys. If we have the good time here, then everything is set. Oh, Anish wins. Anish wins. Just as we set this up, Anish has won. Meanwhile, what about Vidit? Because if Vidit wins, then the match will go on for quite some time, yeah? Because then he fights back. Yeah, Vidit. Okay, he won the game, right? He won the game, the last one. Got it. Okay. So now we are all set here. I have to update the scores. Chat, let me know if I am right or wrong. If I have made any mistakes, then let me know. But yeah, this looks good. Vidit now playing with white. Okay, let's focus on this game for now. G6 has a nice position. Bishop h6 attacking the rook. Vidit is going to swing his rook over here on the king side, and it's going to be a brutal attack. Wrong? What? VD is on 2.5. No, I updated it. Oh, okay. I had to just... but that is updated. Okay. Good. So now all scores updated. Let's look at Anish's game. Yeah. Anish has... in this position, white pieces. He just needs 2 points more. I think, guys, Anish is going to be through here. He's played his knight to d4. Maybe the queen can go to b3. He can look at this e6 square weakness. Oh, Nils 1.5. Okay. I made a mistake. Instead of turning Vidit into that, I made Nils that. Okay. Thanks, chat. Thank you so much for correcting all of this. Oh, meanwhile, f5 has been played by Howell. Vidit goes knight c5. Is this a good move? Maybe. e6 pawn under pressure. Maybe he will go bishop f6, or he can even take the knight on c5. But then that will open up the rook here. He plays queen, takes on c5 and plays queen f6. I like with its position here. Because guys, look at this. He plays rook g3. He has certain threats like bishop g5. Trapping. Maybe the queen would be in trouble there. Also, there are threats of pushing the h pawn down the board. Knight g6 could be an idea. Here. Interesting position for Vidit. Well, one would imagine that Vidit is a favorite when it comes to playing against Howell. But yesterday, David Howell did beat Jordan Van Forest. And so, definitely, Vidit is having a tough time, and also he's trailing in the match. Anish, very steady, yeah? Very steady. Opposite color bishops, but a nice pawn structure. You remember how Anish had beaten Grandelius Nils in Tata Steel? Yeah, chess 24 bar you cannot really trust, because it just keeps going up down. Oh, bishop b5. What's this move, guys? If I take queen takes b5, he wants to come queen e5, or does he want to play knight c3? Maybe queen e5. Oh, he takes. Okay. For Vidit, every game is very critical. Can you take the pawn on b7? Guys, can you pick up the pawn here? Threaten? No, Vidit goes h4. He wants to go H5. Guys, don't be affected by the bar. The bar is drunk. The best thing about these boards is that the time is very accurate. Remove the bar. Knight c6. Okay. Amrita, we don't have to make any moves. We just have to watch. We just have to watch.
Alright.
Knight c6. Now, I'm wondering if Vidit can win the pawn on b7. It looks like a nice pawn, although not a juicy pawn. Here.
Which pawn you said is very
simple? B7.
B7. Queen b7. Yeah, but then after queen b7.
I'm also wondering, Amruta.
And I think it will become very
he strong. He took.
Oh, knight d4?
Yeah, but knight d4. I mean, what? Your threat is knight e2, I agree. He went rook c7.
Rook c7, queen a6, that's fine.
Yeah.
Now go knight d4. But okay, there is no real threat if you save knight e2. Knight c3, good move. Good move, you win the bishop.
Which bishop? No, he attacks the queen. Where does the queen move?
Queen f6. Do you want to take on c5?
I'm wondering queen c5, rook c1, yeah. Because if knight e2, oh, rook c1.
Oh, queen c5 is a mistake, rook c1.
Yeah. Oh, queen b5 was his idea. David Howell, very, very strong.
Ah, very smart.
Okay, can we take on b5, queen a1? Oh my god, look at this. If the knight moves, there's a mate on g7. Guys, there is a mate here threatened on this square. You see the bishop and the queen. Looking here, oh, let me one mate. No, there's no mate. There's room.
Guys, please excuse. You know, we have had a long stream. This can happen. Rook b7, rook b7. All right. Knight has finally come to d4. But you know, in 25 seconds to keep playing this position is very risky for both the sides. At some point,
both the sides.
Play h5 as soon as you can, I believe.
Yeah.
All the more opening that h file there. Now, slowly, I'm starting to like Vidit's position more. Because his rook and his queen, they have pushed. What king h8?
Don't.
Forget the bar.
Can we remove the bar?
Yeah, no, it's funny. It's there. Let it exist. But that's what people will understand that, okay, ignore. Itna bhi aadat nahi. Be independent. You know, guys, be independent.
But the bar is like this, it's just going up and down. Wow, rook goes in. What? Queen f2?
Queen f2?
Oh, he blundered. Mouse.
Oh, no, pre-move. He thought queen f1 and king h2, queen f2.
Oh.
So he played queen f2.
Oh, it wins. Oh, it wins.
What a turnover. Oh, you
turnover rate, turn around. Turnover is basically the sales of a company. Oh, by the way, Anish has won. He's moved to 5.5 points. Wow, Anish.
So he needs only 1 point.
Anish is brutal.
He needs one. Yeah, guys, bar dancing. Please remove bar. Heart attack. I think if we had time, which we right now do not, we would have taken a vote whether you prefer a bar or not, e4 or d4. But right now
no votes, guys.
Yeah,
just going to flip the board here so that we can follow this way.
Yeah, so it's Grunfeld, right?
Yeah, it's Grunfeld. Mm-hmm. Rook b1. Mm-hmm. Yeah, it's Grunfeld. Fianchetto,
do you want more?
Mm-hmm.
Oh, they have also, this is very equal, right?
Yeah.
Nothing here. Can I say that?
Should be around equal.
Mm-hmm. Boomer reference. Aksharata says chess 24 bar is like Johnny Lever from Dulhe Raja. Tu meri taraf hai ki uski taraf hai. उंगली उसकी तरफ है लेकिन दिल आपकी तरफ है. अक्षय ना तो यू रियली हैव अ नैक ऑफ यू नो मेकिंग दीज रेफरेंसेस एंड थैंक्स फॉर मेकिंग अस लाफ.
Oh, but here, Amruta, even though Vidit is a pawn up, the bishops, white bishops are very powerful with the rook looking at b1 on b7 square. So it may end up as a slightly tense position for Vidit because he may lose b7 pawn and the rook may come to b7 for white. Like white's rook will then infiltrate here and then a7 pawn might get weak. So we do
so,
not.
So if nothing, black can just give away the b7 pawn, keep this bishop here, basically.
No, but
and yeah, you, somewhere here.
If you go there, rook b7.
Okay, so he plays rook b8 first.
But now bishop he's a7, then rook a8. Okay.
So he's wanting to take a2 after bishop.
Yeah, isn't it 3.5? I have updated, guys. 3.5, 3.5. Yeah, the score is updated.
Yes, score is updated. For all those people who wanted to know what Sagar was eating biryani and salad.
Biryani and salad. You know, it's like dream of Samai. He wants to eat biryani all the time. There's a video on his channel that he doesn't do. He's doing everything to eat biryani.
Yeah, yeah.
But if he mixes it with salad, you feel good. You know, one unhealthy, one healthy stuff.
No, biryani is healthy. It has veggies. I mean, basically, we do it when we are on screen.
But our biryani is not
so
like biryani.
You don't mix everything. It's like?
It's healthy. Real biryani is never healthy.
Kuch bhi. Okay. We will argue on that later. But right now, in this position, it's Sicilian.
Anish has played knight to f6.
And what move should we go for? If you can take from the first move.
No. Okay. Let's not go from the first move.
Sagar is right now.
Just Amruta, I'm
very
just saying
chill,
one
very
thing.
Very relaxed, yes.
That if Anish wins this match is over. Five
we
and
have
half.
To focus on this match.
No. Because he has 4-point lead. So he's going to win this match. That's what I believe.
Okay, one second. He has chosen to keep his queen on b7 and his bishop is on c8. Very interesting.
No, Sagar. now take on c6, queen c6, rook d3. If the rook jumps from here and then goes to h3, that would be very powerful. Oh, he's played it. Nils, well done, Nils. Now he's going to h3. He's going to then take on f6 and try to make...
E5, I'll play E5, stopping rook h3 and your dreams are over.
But then this bishop's dream begin, no, Amruta? When you play E5 pawn, trying to protect with your bishop the h3 square, this bishop would get very happy on this diagonal.
Haan, toh rehne do na, it can be happy.
No, he played. He played.
You have to stop. He played. You have to stop.
He played it.
Oh my god. Okay. The bar.
Rook f3. Yeah, this is a good.
So is there an exchange sacrifice which is going to happen? Bishop f6? Bishop f6?
Yes, and there is also bishop d5 which you have to worry about winning the rook. Okay, meanwhile, what about with it? Oh, it draw incoming, guys. They drew.
Next game they will play. Vidit will be white, I believe.
Yeah, Vidit will be white. So the score goes to 4-4. What a match we are having. This is going to go down the wire.
Vidit on 4 and David on 4 and up.
No, 4-4. Amruta is saying Vidit on 4 and David on 4 and half. Are kaise hota hai Amruta? Every point has to be full if they're playing each other. Oh, look at Anish. Anish got his rook to g8.
Oh, bishop f7, isn't he losing a pawn?
I don't
exactly.
know. Yeah, this time I think Bar's reaction is pretty okay. Look at Bar.
Bar is dead, I think. Just forget it.
Bar was like...
Bar is like, kaise ullu banaya tumko? It's something like
no,
that.
No, Bar was like, how can Anish give up the f7 pawn? That means Nils actually is making a comeback here with at least one win in this position now.
Too early to say.
Can we not take this guy on g8? What is the problem? Oh, he's picked up a knight here.
Yeah. So after bishop g8, you get two pieces for rook. But with white really attacking.
I have an idea. bg6 and then next move take on f6 and mate.
Oh my god.
And if bg6, no, and if bg6, if you play h6, then I will take with my bishop.
Oh my god. So is bishop g6 losing actually?
Okay.
Oh, he
played it. Oh, Anish is losing.
There has to be a defense. No, Sagar.
What? No, Sagar. But what happened? Why have they not started? Why has Vidit versus Howell not begun, guys?
So, for a moment, can you show that? Because there has to be defense.
No defense, no defense, Amruta. Resign. Anish resigned.
Oh.
Anish resigned. Nice win by Grandel, yes.
I think he missed BG6.
I think after 8 games, they are taking a small break or what? No, this game has begun already. Anish started with D4.
They take a break.
Nils is now up to 2.5. Still, he is like on that match point situation. He cannot be confident. Oh, it's a Grunfeld. Grunfeld. Anish is a big Grunfeld expert from black side. Now he's playing with white. What about Vidit's game?
Not yet started. When it starts, I think they
will be
washroom break. Exactly.
Okay. Good. Guys, I was just checking if Leeches is working or not.
You can refresh and check it out until the...
Oh, it's working.
Oh, okay, cool. Let's see here.
No, but if it doesn't work then...
you have that ready, na?
It's ready.
I have two windows.
Like this. BG5 is played. Here there is no BG5
played. No, but you can't see. You will have to adjust that Leeches.
No, this is okay. Guys, we have to unfortunately see it here.
So the bar over on Leeches is good, yeah?
Good, yeah?
No, say na. Is it good?
It's good. Over there it's
wrong. So you can have the Leeches bar here on the side.
No.
Okay, fine.
But then moves are not updating only.
Leeches.
Guys, you have to make do with the board today.
Once.
Are but it's not working now, Amruta. What
you said it's working.
Are they are lagging. After every few moves, we have to wait. And then after some, you are like, oh, time is going to have time. Oh, he had made his move. So that's no fun. So we'll look at it here.
Okay.
Vidit's game started. Okay, this is around equal, guys. Anish has this nice pawn center. Let's look at what Vidit has played. Oh. Some moves, but very quickly we can rush. D4, D5, C4, C6, Knight F3. Oh, Slow. E3, Bishop C4. Take. IQP position, guys. Bishop E7, Castle. I think Vidit is enjoying these IQP positions against Howell. A5 gaining space. Maybe at some point he will then swing his rook over like this.
Oh, wow.
Yeah, but it's going to be later. Oh, Amruta, Bishop G5.
Yeah.
And then you have a typical IQP position. This is very interesting. And also in blitz, with 5 minutes on the clock, white usually has good attacking chances.
Yes. And Sagar, exactly. Like the light square bishop, you want it on this diagonal, right? This one?
Yeah.
Why are you laughing?
No, people are saying that why are you fighting like husband and wife? Oh, you are husband and wife. Yeah. Oh, but I didn't like Bishop F4 by Vidit because now the two, a pair of minor pieces have been exchanged and somehow Black has stabilized the position.
Exactly, that's what I'm saying.
Also, the Bishop on G3 is not so great, but I think Vidit's plan...
F4, F5.
No. He's not going to play against the King. I think he will play against these pawns somehow. He'll try to play on the Queen side.
Play against those pawns.
See, he will go bishop somewhere, move bishop b3, then he will go knight c4, knight b. I don't know, this is how Vidit will do some.
He actually played bishop.
See, h3. He will not go very aggressive. I think this is comfortable for Black. Let's look at very quickly what Anish is doing. Because one loss can start a tilt, guys.
The first thing Anish has managed is take control of his time and.
But I think Amruta, Black is great. Black is great. He's going to win the b5 pawn next.
If you take b5, knight d5.
Yeah, just move the queen maybe.
Queen
f7.
Queen f7, knight c7.
Okay. I like Nils' position and maybe Nils might get another win in. That would lead to 3.5, 5.5.
No. Look at this idea. Knight d5, queen f7, knight c7. Okay. Now your a7 is hanging in b5.
No, a7 is not hanging.
My rook was on a1, no? No?
Yeah, exchanged.
Okay.
He played bd6. Good move.
Yeah. It's still some time for Black to open up his g7 bishop.
I think Black is doing well here. But let's look at what Howell has done. He went knight c6. Okay, he went knight c6. Guys, all the score and all is good, right? No mistakes as of now. We are all under control. So no now, mistakes. With knight going to c6, he's attacking the a5 pawn. If you see, if Vidit is careless, then knight takes a5 will hang. So Vidit is thinking what to do. He doesn't want to exchange the knights, because when you have an isolated pawn, you don't want to exchange pieces. But here he may be forced to do that. Or how about knight c4, Amruta? Knight c4.
Yeah, that plan which you suggested after knight c4. What do you want to do? Do you want
to go to b6? No, but I wanted to go to b6. Then I saw the knight on d5 controls that. So I thought maybe that's not great.
I would seriously consider f4. But bishop b4 is a big problem. You know, losing the...
Oh, he played bishop a4. Can we not take on a5, the pawn? What is the problem? Can we not just win this pawn?
But anyway, we're losing. That's what I'm saying. Bishop b4 was the...
Oh, look, Amruta. If knight a5, Vidit wants to go knight d7, hitting the rook. And after rook e8, he might have some discovered ideas. Discovered attack ideas. Maybe knight c5.
No.
Maybe knight c5. Hitting this rook here and then b7. Oh, he's taken it.
Knight
f6, two pieces.
No, I thought if not knight f6, bishop e8, you can't take with the queen.
Ah. Oh, he went knight e5. What's this? Can we not go knight c6? Ah, knight c6, he wants to take with the bishop. Pawn takes, rook takes.
Tricky.
Oh, b5. David says, Vidit, what's your plan? Vidit says, I want to go to c2. I want to attack you on the king.
There is pressure on f7.
Hey, Amruta.
Lovely position.
Amruta, look at this.
Guys. Lovely position.
If bishop h7 was a threat, bishop h7, king h7, queen h5. But now g6.
Now f4, he's given bishop h4.
No, a5 is hanging. Bishop h4, bishop h4, rook a5.
Well taken advantage.
LPDO, guys.
And knight b4, bishop b1.
Knight c4. Can we go knight c4? I think Vidit won't care about this pawn.
Maybe
yeah, he went.
No,
b3, knight c3. B3, knight c3, forking.
Ah, I can't do that.
So let's give... Oh, look. He doesn't care. He's like, I want to go.
Complete aggressive move.
Because if you take on b2, I'll take on g6. I'll open up your king. He's going full on crazy in there.
Yeah, he's going crazy. Bar is going crazy. Everyone in the chat also.
Guys, what happened with Anish's game? We want to quickly switch, but we just Vidit's attack is so addictive to watch. We don't want to leave this. Okay, very quickly, let's steal a glance. What's happening? Very interesting.
Anish has got
this d pawn is very quick. D pawn is
with
very
the a pawn. Yeah.
So okay, Anish is right now quite
winning.
Okay.
Anish is winning.
Maybe not sure whether he's winning or not, but is fine, Amruta.
Okay.
Oh, knight b4 is a cool move. Hitting the rook and also the bishop on c2, which is your main piece.
I wouldn't say I don't care about that and something like
that. Stack on bishop g6, yeah.
Fg6.
I think he should take on g6.
Are you serious?
Vidit will take. But Vidit's time is just 1 minute 14 seconds. Guys, the score is 4-4 and the first one to reach 6.5 points wins the match. So Vidit may reach 5, but... I mean, if he wins this, if he loses, he will be on 4. Howell will reach 5. It's still some games away, this match, from reaching the finish line. I think this is the critical moment of this match, Amruta. Whoever wins this, and he takes it. He takes on g6, fg. What's the plan? Oh, queen moves in. Queen takes g6 is an idea.
But, is it maximum power pitch here?
No. Maybe that could be more attack. Like, for example, knight a6.
Knight a6. What
queen g6.
Queen g6, bishop g7.
Bishop g7, queen f7.
King h8, queen h5 you have.
No, I'm also thinking, Amruta, can we some point lift our rook from d1 to d3 to h3, or maybe move the bishop here? Somehow, I feel like Howell must be in tension right now. Because these are the positions, like, you know, Amruta, look at this. Queen g6, bg7, knight f7, hitting the queen with the ideas of knight h6, knight g5. It's not simple to play such a position.
Yeah, with 1 minute, definitely not simple. Oh, ag1 in the meantime, that's the news.
Oh, ag1?
Yes.
Oh, ag has won the match then. Ag has won the match then. That's over, guys. 6.5 points to Anish Giri.
Yeah.
Too good. Oh, by the way, some moves did happen. What happened? He took on e5. And then take. And now queen e7. Oh, because the queen was hanging. Amruta, rook on d1 was attacking the queen.
both of us missed it, yeah?
No, but right... No, he took on E5, Amrutha.
Haan, after what. That. Okay. That I didn't see.
Rugdi 6?
96.
What?
96?
What is with it doing?
Oh, his idea is 96, ED6, then go Bishop E5.
No, no. ED6, yeah. And if you move D7. The Queen D7, uh-huh. And if you play Queen D7, then Queen G6, Bishop E5.
Wow, what a move. Oh, but only 28 seconds. But he's so alert for tactics today with its calculation is excellent. Somehow, David must think, right?
Yeah, he's putting David under a lot of pressure, but David has managed to keep a 20-second lead here on the clock.
Yeah.
I think Vidit really just took a lot of risk somehow, no, Amrutha?
Too much risk.
Too much risk.
This much risk, I don't think we've seen him taken. But look at the time. Now they are both on 20 seconds. That's another good news with this risk.
And also,
Rook D7, of course.
Rook E7.
Now Rook D8 check.
No, can we take on G6? Yeah, King F8.
Yeah, simple.
Can we? Whoa, look at this rook lift. Fourth rank rook lifts are quite rare. Yeah, Amrutha, usually you lift on third ranks. Now Rook H4. Oh, the rook comes in. Wow, this time the bar is right. This time the bar is right, guys. Because if Queen G7,
that, that's what I'm saying. Like Rook G4 was a finish or what? Queen G8 was a threat. Queen
F8. But this is over. This is over. He wins the queen.
Wow.
Moves to 5 points.
He sacrificed a piece. He sacrificed a rook. He sacrificed so much.
Guys, VDOP in the chat. What a game.
The best game of Vidit I have witnessed.
I'm not sure how accurate it was.
No, that is what is about chess. Sagar.
What, to play inaccurate chess?
That's beautiful. Inaccurate chess is really beautiful.
Mm. So there is beauty in imperfection, you say, yeah?
Yes, absolutely. Okay. Vidit OP, guys. Vidit OP, 9,000 people have seen.
Oh, isn't that why they put this black tikka behind these little kids? Because it's like, you look so perfect. With this black tikka, you are imperfect. So, tumko kisi ki nazar na lag jaye, something like that, right?
This is what right now you are understanding.
Okay, Rook C1. We have this Nimzo Indian. And now, C7 pawn is under pressure here. If you see the queen and rook. But at the same time, White's king is in the center. So if you are going
C5.
To
C5, I would like to play C5, Dc5, Knight, Knight. No.
Am I very loud, guys? So okay, I'll reduce my sound. Okay, if I'm very loud, just let me know. I'm not shouting on the top of my voice. It's just that the positions are very exciting.
Yeah, you are too close to the mic. Maybe that's
okay.
We have only these two, right? After this, we don't have anyone.
Yeah, these are the last four games.
Okay.
Three games.
C5. He's got in C5. And now Rook C8. Bishop E2, Rook C8. Go Rook C8.
Hmm. Oh, but Amrutha, he didn't have time to actually take on C7. Like, he gave up the C7 pawn.
No, you can't take. It's a blunder.
Why?
Rook C8.
Ooh, Rook C8. Ah.
And Rook C1, it's over.
Rook C1, King D2. Okay, it's possible still, but okay. Yeah. There was compensation. Queen A5. Queen F4, G5.
G5? What?
This could be with its prep. Knight E4. And castle. No, now, yeah. Can we go H5? Is that a possibility to trap that bishop? But there is Bishop H5. D6. A6. Yeah, he plays A6.
Actually, he's playing on both the wings.
He's looking to play b5. I think such positions are very risky in blitz because your king on g8 is slightly exposed. Your opponent has the bishop pair. But Vidit is having good faith in his abilities right now. He's thinking that, well, whatever is the best that needs to be done. Can we go c4, Amrutha? Close down that position.
C4? Really? Yeah,
c4.
Yes, I think I would always love such a move.
But c4, he goes rook c8. He says, why should I commit? Why should I release the tension?
Okay. White will simply go queen b1 maybe. You can't have that queen on such an open file. Queen b1, bishop b3, right?
Ha ha. Possible. No, but you are losing queen e4, Amrutha. Don't lose that knight.
First, I'll have to play knight f6.
But then the bishop gets on e5. Yeah. The square. Bishop gets the e5 square. So, right now...
So, f5, maybe he will think of ideas like f5.
Queen b1. He played queen b1.
Queen b1. Now, Vidit will play... Maybe h5 right now is a good idea.
F5 I don't like because your e5 square is weakened. So, queen e7. You don't always need to make...
Very solid and calm move.
Yeah, very, very calm move there.
No, I just thought VD was playing in super aggressive manner, so that's how he's going to continue, but...
With white, he was doing that. With black, maybe you don't go so ultra ballistic. Yeah. Okay, bishop e5, why is this a blunder? What?
No,
the bar is as always crazy, but knight
but
b3...
something like knight f2, king f2, knight e4 check, king...
Amruta, I like knight b3. Knight b3. Because knight b3, if rook c8, rook c8.
Yeah, knight b3, rook c8, rook c8.
Yeah, you get the c file.
Yeah. Actually, too many tempting options for black in that sense. You also have now bishop b3 is a possibility because this knight is protected. Karthik says the bar definitely spent a lot of time at the bar asking the bartender for a refill. Bar.
A nice one.
Good use of bar.
Now f6.
Now knight b3.
Now knight b3. Hitting the bishop.
E5 also you can play.
Yeah.
If you want.
Somehow these pawns which have advanced, which looked like weaknesses, Vidit has shored it up well with this move f6. And maybe then e5. And he has a light squared bishop. So those cover the light squares.
Yes. And look at this. Sometimes you can go g4. Kick this knight away from here. Then keep your pawn on f5. Get this bishop here.
Now you can't play f5 because the king is, well, it will be paid.
After g4, knight b3. Yeah, you need your knight on b3. But overall, I love Vidit's pieces, especially these minor pieces. These three minor pieces together.
So how about,
so well coordinated.
How about taking off this one of the piece with bishop c5 here? I would like to take that out.
To remove some tension on the board.
Yeah.
Bishop c5, rook c5. And then you get your knight to d4. Yes, that's good. I would say that's good.
Okay, he took.
He took actually.
Knight takes. Oh, and now Amruta, bishop e4. We played knight to d4. I like bishop e4 because it pushes the queen to a1. Very uncomfortable square. The queen doesn't have space.
Yeah, also...
But queen, yeah.
There is no bishop d3 possible.
Look at this, Amruta. A2 maybe. Bishop e4.
Yeah.
Queen a1, e5. Oh, he goes knight b3. I think Vidit understands that when he's in the lead, not to take too many risks.
Yeah.
So if you can exchange pieces and then get this number of games lower. So now he's on 5-4. He'll reach 5.5.
Need only another draw. But you know what I'm worried position is? Takes. And if at all I'm able to get my queen and bishop in as a battery, then these squares are...
It's not so easy.
Not easy, yeah?
It'll take a lot of time.
That is true. Rook c8. This c file is controlled. It's such a big relief. And d file, you have this bishop.
Oh, h4.
Trying to that's chip. What it says.
No, he's just trying to chip away at the king side. It might not even be that he's trying to attack black. It might be that he's trying to get rid of his back rank weakness.
Yeah. Now just rook c5, queen c7, maybe.
Or queen c7 directly. Yes, he plays queen c7. Because he wants to go queen c1 or queen c2.
Yeah, the queen exchange would be fine. So white will go rook d1 back.
No, rook d1, queen c2.
You can't stop both, right?
Yeah, you can't.
So rook d2. Maybe go rook d2. So that you can allow queen c1 is okay. Keep the rook on d2 and...
But Howell is a pawn down, point down in the match.
Plus even this endgame after queen exchange, agar queen c1, rook c1, black's king and the pawns, they have more space. So it's already a bad position. It's highly possible that positionally Vidit will convert this. All look at the time.
Now queen c2.
Queen c2 for sure.
Yeah, Amruta, you are saying Vidit may convert this, but I think it's quite far away. The position is right now around even, no? He played queen c1.
Yeah.
Just taking no risks, getting the queens off the board.
Queen c1, rook c1. Okay, he doesn't take.
He played rook d2, so the b2 pawn is protected. Okay. How do you continue now? Do you play bishop b3?
Yes, f5. Exactly. Exactly. Ah, this is all. Because now you can just start king f6. King. And also e4 is stopped.
King f6, king e5. No?
Yeah. G4, g4 I like. This is also great.
F3 fighting back.
Maro, gf. Gf, king f6 now.
King g3.
Rook g1.
No, rook g1 q. King, rook g1 q. King e5. Yeah.
Okay, king e5.
Oh, but don't.
Now f4 check is going to come.
Black okay. looks slightly more active, slightly, not much, but his king is slight. Oh, he
now
comes
go
back.
E5.
Ah, huh? Black, but bishop f5.
Okay, okay.
Yeah. So let's.
Is Vidit, maybe Vidit will go rook c1 back. Oh, this is too fast. 20 seconds more.
No, now king e5. Amruta, I like black
oh,
position.
Oh, white pawn on e5. That's a great
yeah,
provocation.
Yeah, king e5. King e5.
I think it was too early for now e4 Howard
is
to
weak.
Play that.
Take on e4, bishop e4, but then, oh, he plays rook c2.
He's not giving any chance. Oh, rook d1.
No,
rook
d5.
Rook d1, bishop
I think
d5.
Black is winning. Amruta, Vidit has somehow managed to get this magical coordination. His king coming in, bishop running.
Check. Bishop e4 check.
Yeah, yeah. He's winning this, guys. He'll reach to 6 points. Now bd3.
Wow.
Take on b2, take on a6. King here. Whoa, he has no time actually. How does he play so quickly? Rook h2, threatening a mate. Oh, he has won.
Oh, because 20 seconds more, he can't stop the mate. Amazing, forced mate.
Rook wow.
Great play, such calmness. I mean, the earlier game, total bloodbath. And now, such calmness. I mean, amazing.
Well played with it.
Really,
and you know,
really.
He
10,000
was...
people like the stream, guys. How Vidit has played with it OP in the chat.
Yeah, with it OP. He's now going to reach, has only half a point needed. He was, Amruta, he started off with 2-0 loss. With
they are playing right now again?
Yeah.
Oh, it's going on.
What? Six and half you need.
Okay. Okay, it's going on, guys.
And with it, you know, when he has to just win, exchange Slav is what he goes to. You know, it's his go-to opening when he wants to play without risk.
So with white, he only needs a draw.
Yeah.
But David is in a great form.
Yeah, but with exchange Slav, what can you do? I mean, against Vidit, this positional genius, and you're playing, he's playing exchange Slav. He wants to draw. He has white pieces. I don't think David can do much. In fact, if you try too hard, by the way, knight b4 a threat, so a3 you will play, stopping that. Plays queen e2, okay.
Yeah, castle. Even in this, it's like Sagar in exchange Slav. Do you go for attacks with, like, suppose the knight is on f6, h4, h5, h6, or something
no,
like
no.
that? No,
no. Depend. Here he will just castle, Amruta. He will just play safe. He won't take risks.
So when you want to basically irritate your opponent, that you don't have any chances to attack as such, if you like to attack, you play exchange Slav. I like how David has tried to play knight h5 and f5, trying to get whatever play he can still manage.
Yeah.
It's nice.
Well, that's generally how these must-win scenarios pan out.
Yeah.
You try too hard.
Mm-hmm.
Once in every 4 or 5 games, you are successful.
Yeah.
But most of the times, you create weaknesses which are then not salvageable. You know, they become huge weaknesses.
True. So, oh, he's repeating.
No, he'll repeat only once. And Vidit may even not move his bishop, because if the knight takes the bishop, I'm okay to take with the pawn. What don't, I mean, of course he won't draw now, not knight h5.
But why did Vidit have to think so much? Because he took 10 seconds or more.
He plays knight e4.
Vidit has to save his time.
Now knight e5.
Yes, and at the right time, maybe play f3. Allow knight takes e3. Or will you take on e4 with the bishop?
Yeah, knight takes, that is good. F3
takes.
Is a good idea.
Too many tempting options for white. Bishop f6. Maybe black will try to go bishop e8. A6, b5. What? How should black play? If he tries to go something like g5 and all, we definitely know it's going to break. Oh, he plays g5.
Oh, he plays it.
Yeah, I think it's the only way if you want to create any counter play.
But
But then at the
Amruta,
end, exactly, Vidit will be happy because finally it's been provoked.
yeah, that's what I mean. He might well be creating a lot of weaknesses that he may not be able to defend. Like Queen H5 may come
Yeah.
in.
Yeah, with Bishop c6. The question is, do you want to keep the queen on h5 so that later you go f3, or you don't really care about the attack over there and start with kicking away the knight? Because one thing is sure, now you don't want to take on e4.
Yeah. I think f3 is there, but he would first put the queen on h5, but then
Yeah.
there is bishop e8 to kick the queen away.
Queen
So
h6 I
I think
always have. No,
now I
bishop
want to
e8, queen
play.
h6 is fine. You lose, e6 is hanging and g7 is the mate.
Ah, okay.
So guys, queen h5, if bishop e8, then there is queen h6 with mate
Ah.
or
So can I
e6.
start with bishop e8 here? Stopping queen h5.
Yeah. What's happened?
Oh, how well, what happened?
Why is the game stuck? Board freeze.
Ah, it's back, it's back.
Oh, okay.
It's back. It came back, but I just did refresh unnecessarily. But okay, now it's back.
Okay. So what did he play for Bishop c6 in that game?
No, so what happened was here we were thinking a lot. So he took bishop e5, knight d6, knight b5, exchange. Oh, and Howell says my knight is better than your bishop. Vidit may not
Is it
agree.
really? I'm
Vidit
not
may not
sure.
agree.
Yeah, it like momentarily maybe yes, but
But generally, if you want to play for a win, the best way is to create imbalances.
correct. But now rook c8 is strong. Black is trying to take c5, but and a2 is also weak. So yes, you have to go rook c8. Black gets some initiative here, some initiative. White must be careful. Vidit needs to be careful.
Yeah.
h6. Sagar, now maybe at some point queen h5 will be strong because there are not enough pieces on queen side.
Ooh,
Oh, g4!
G4.
Whoa!
Guys, you see, these moves are ones which can surprise any normal chess player. He's like, Vidit is playing solidly, solidly, draw karega. And then suddenly G4, you're like, why? Because I think Vidit was getting a bit tense that black has the open C file, his queen is active, his knight may jump to C4. So he said, let me open a front on the king side, at least something.
Yeah, and I love this move because you could even go f4
Yeah.
later. You already have well-placed rook. You're opening another file here.
Possible,
g4, what
possible.
a move. Practically, I would say
Good
wonderful
move, good
idea,
move.
which I've learned.
Do you think he'll go F4 also now?
Yes, he can.
The
He
king on
should. The
G7 is a
best
bit
part is the
lonely.
c1, c2, c3, c4, c5. All the squares are controlled on this file. So it's a show-off file.
Yeah.
What happened?
No, now maybe rook F8. Oh, he
Queen
plays queen
f7.
F7.
Queen g. If you go queen g3, attack the knight here with the idea of f4. I like queen g3. Okay, he played gf5. But look at the time. Yes.
I think David has managed to at least put some pressure on with it. Some. Even though the position is around even, he has definitely managed to tell with it that look, you won't get an easy draw. Now, nice move, queen
Yeah,
e5.
because it removes a lot of tension from the position.
But you don't touch that queen. If you take d, then maybe you'll. Oh, he took and knight
Ah,
e4.
now you always have a choice of going into the
Amruta,
rook heading at the right time. F3?
f3. F3, now knight d2 force, otherwise you lose f5 pawn. I think Vidit is winning. Rook d1, rook, no,
What?
rook d1, rook, rook f2, rook f2. Rook f2. Abhi f5 mar raha hai.
But
Take on f5.
e5 is also hanging na, Sagar.
हाँ, दैट इज ट्रू.
तो e6 खेलना है क्या? बट देन किंग f6, f4 खेल दो. दैट्स व्हाई पहले f4. ठीक है,
और डू
अभी
यू वॉन्ट टू प्ले. ओ, नुक्स, नाइस, रुक
नो
सी टू.
एक्चुअली.
बिकॉज नाउ यू कांट टेक ऑन e5.
हाँ, रुक c2 इज नाइस. रुक c2 इज नाइस. वी आर फोकसिंग ओनली ऑन यू नो किंग साइड. रुक c6,
Now threatening knight e5.
मे बी बिशप f5, नाइट टेक
Oh, he
c5.
goes
He
into
goes into rook
the.
endgame. He doesn't take a chance of going into minor piece
But
endgame.
Amruta, this endgame might not be so simple.
f4,
Black has a
how?
queenside majority. And also the black king can come easily from e6 to d5, can jump to the center.
No, but white can always keep the rook on e2. And after king d5, you don't have progress there.
Rook e2. No,
my
no,
king
thing...
is also going to come from here, no?
No, no. Your king does not have entry. Ah, you're cutting my king off.
Okay, I don't know how this will be draw, but you can look how Vidit plays and maybe you'll understand. I just feel intuitively this has to be...
That Albert Einstein story, no?
Which
Albert Einstein goes with his driver to a ceremony and he tells his driver to give a lecture, and then the driver was asked a question, and driver says this is so easy, my driver will answer it. But the driver is Albert Einstein, you see. Oh my god.
Later,
oh my god,
he's gone a little crazy. But oh, 3 pawns, 2 pawns, this is difficult.
Oh,
huh?
This is, look, see, Amruta, it was not so simple. Black rook got very active now.
Keep your king on h2, okay? This has to be a book draw, I think. Keep your king on h2. Without the e5 pawn, Sagar, and h4 pawn, yeah, this would, black would be winning there.
I think black will win this
No. You keep your rook on a7, then rook a6. If you are able to cut off the king, definitely not. King can't come up because e6
is he came up.
Yeah, now rook e6.
But he can play king
e4,
f3.
Then e6.
King f3. I'm not sure.
E7.
I'm not sure. This seems like...
King g3, rook g6 check.
Great. But just for a moment, guys, we need to appreciate David Howell. He's kept ahead on time. He's pawn up. He's created his chances against Vidit's solid exchange slow. You really have to be a class act to do that. Okay. Pawns are exchanged. Ah, draw.
Pawn is a book draw, guys. Book draw.
Draw. He loses the pawn on... What? Checkmate.
Oh, no.
Primo. He made a primo. You know, Amruta, check here. He went here. Aray, yaar, he had to give a check. What a trick by David Howell. Vidit thought he will take the pawn. He will take the pawn here. That's why he went here. What a trick. Oh my god.
I can't believe it. Oh my god. This will be so heartbreaking right now.
Yeah, this is like a mental shock to Vidit. Because now, can he recover?
Immediately next game, man. Okay, come on, Vidit. Come on, Vidit. Fight.
Now Alapin. Now he has black pieces.
Guys, but like, can't even imagine that you have only not even 0.01 second of recovery, and this is so
tough.
Yeah.
That's the format. This but you know, that position he had reached was a typical Philidor position.
Yeah, it was a dead draw. Kuch bhi karwate
he just made a pre-move there, and that's the thing, what happens when you have very little time. You think I'll make a pre-move? Because Amruta, flagging is there.
I can't believe. Yeah, it's like the bullet tricks, right? This flagging is a very different style of end mein kuch twist kar sakte.
Correct.
Types.
You can never say it's a draw because there is no increment.
So,
but good play by Howell. Yeah, overall, it was a good one. Now 5-6, still Vidit just needs a draw. So, but will this affect him? This result, because
this game will show that absolutely. I mean, nothing else but this game.
B6, good move, because you want to play bishop a6, exchange when your opponent has a pair of bishops, you want to exchange it. Also, the pawns on d4 and c3, which are hanging pawns for white, could become a strength, but they could also be weaknesses. Yeah.
And also, this game could even affect him in a positive way. That more aggressive, that I can't lose this. You know, I'm going to beat you. That kind of.
But,
yeah, possible.
If he had just got a draw, he would have finished the match. So, what is there to be?
No. But right now, there is a definite possibility, right? That it can get, you can get affected negatively. Mm-hmm. And you can... people where the mental attitude is not, you know, they're not so strong mentally, they can keep losing. Happens to many people.
Now I want to play a5, because if I don't do, and if white gets b5, oh, he plays b5, because I don't want this pawn to become a weakness.
And c3 is a backward
oh,
pawn.
Look at this,
that's
is a positional c4. Nice move, because knight bd7, knight b6, knight c4, or knight b6,
knight
a4.
Yeah, knight d5 and knight a4. I think c3 is going
nice
to be
move.
Lost.
Nice move. But maybe rook a5 exists, Samrutha.
No, what white needs to do
oh,
is
rook a5,
rook
good
a5,
move.
Then rook a1, and then somehow go knight e5 and try for c4. No. Get rid of this weakness here.
There's no time. See, oh, he gives up this pawn. No, he doesn't. This is hanging. But pehle bacha lo na king d2 or what? Bd2, bd2. Let's go bd2 and defend it. Bd2, rook a1, rook a1, and then put pressure here. If you go a6,
BD2,
there is rook b5.
Nice.
AB5 को रुके हो 8 मर रहा है।
So again, Vidit needs only a draw and this position. So he need not go for super ambitious attitude. A6, he's gone A6. Rook C8 खेलो, Rook C8. Attack C3. Knight B6 is also good. Now
no, Amruta. Knight B6 was necessary because A8 is now defended. You can't play Rook takes.
Oh, rook takes b4.
Oh, he's coming
now.
Now
the idea can
to
be
take
knight
on b8.
Yeah, because knight a4 and knight c6, this rook will get trapped, Sagar.
Vidit could have was okay with the draw, but Howell says no draw. Let's fight. Let's keep
Sagar,
playing.
Can you not go knight a4?
Ha, you can go knight a4, but
with the idea of knight c6. Rook
but
is
he might give an exchange sack. He may give an exchange sack.
And then start pushing c4 because that is what David wants.
Now.
Oh, wow. Ooh. He doesn't do it.
He's always repeating twice and yes. Then changing the move.
Gaining time. Vidit has 1 minute more.
Now threatening bishop f4 because then to knight d5 he can take on b8 maybe. C3 is defended.
Yeah. 1 minute more. That's great. Come on. Okay, now just bring your king maybe. Start improving your king. Can you do
this
that?
This time Vidit has more time than Howell.
On I
the
said
clock.
Now 1 minute. Were you,
you
not
said
listening?
It? No.
See?
Half of the times I don't listen, Amruta. What is it? Bhav Guru Murthy, thank you.
I don't listen 75% of the times.
Oh, you win, huh? Now, Amruta, knight is coming from e4 to c5 to block the c5. So, every position has some weaknesses but some trumps. So, here c4, c3 pawns are weak. C4 square, c3 pawn. But the knight can sit on c5. Yeah. And then attack, stop the play on c5 and attack a6.
But Sagar, when is black going to start bringing his king to the center? That's my question.
Not now.
When?
I don't. But Amruta, if this game, Howell wins, we go into Armageddon. 6-6 it will happen. And Vidit, look, he realizes his position is in danger. That's why he's taking a lot of time. Knight e4, knight c5. क्योंकि ये नाइट देखो ना दिस नाइट हैज गॉटन जैम्ड अप
इक्वल टू दिस बिशप
ओ कैन वी गो नाइट डी7 बिकॉज़ नाउ यू हैव डिफेंडेड ए6 या ही गोस बट नाउ नाइट सी5
यू
टेक ऑन सी5
बट देन नो दैट्स रिस्की टेक एंड देन व्हाइट विल ओपन विद सी4 एंड देन बी4 बी5 विल बी अ वेरी स्ट्रांग
नाउ थ्रेटनिंग रुक टेक्स बी5 यू कांट मूव दिस रुक बिकॉज़ ए6 हैंग्स
Now you go knight c7.
Yeah, knight c7. Passive. Knight c7. Yeah, true.
Passive is fine. You hold it up. That's why I need your king.
King on g8 is too far from the battle right now.
Exactly,
rook b6.
Exactly.
Oh, knight goes to c5. Can we take?
Oh, knight b8.
This is not going to end well for Vidit. This is not going to end well.
White does not have any breakthrough, Sagar.
No, this can't be true.
c4.
This can't be true. This is too passive.
Oh, c4. Can this you play c4
C4
now?
C4, but take.
King takes.
Rook. Oh, okay.
Oh,
c4 doesn't.
Oh, knight b4, bishop b4, rook b4, king b4, knight c6. You lose a piece.
No. c4, he won't play. g4. Opening up the second front, Amruta. h4.
Principle of two weaknesses.
Yeah.
Now, king f.
Oh, he's bringing your king in.
In fact, white, black will also start creating some weaknesses. I like it. Finally, bring your king with it. Bring your king.
No, he will bring, but. But e6 has become slightly weak. e6 pawn.
Hmm.
You see
pawn
that?
Attack kar raha hai, paru.
Knight kar raha tha na.
Vidit is also going. You, don't forget that at some point this rook will just come to some of the files.
We are going into an Armageddon. I feel we are going 6 all. Man, this is intense, intense action. This is intense action. Rook a3. Will Vidit manage to unravel? Because his knight, rook, and rook, three pieces are stuck defending this sick pawn on a6.
Oh, king e4, you support f3, you attack e5.
I don't like the king coming there. Oh, that looks dangerous, Amruta. That looks very dangerous.
Knight b6. Oh, king e5, knight c4. All the time, these forks, family forks.
Yeah, knights are always tricky. Vidit is playing with this one. You can't. Can you take knight a6 now? Because the rook is blocked. Ooh, bg5, rook d6. Okay.
Yeah, now maybe knight a6. Knight a6, rook a6.
Maybe he's happy that if you take, everything gets exchanged. Howell is not taking. He's not taking.
Hey, now knight c4?
Yeah, possible.
Because.
No, knight c4, rook b5. Rook b5 is coming. That's what his trick is. That a pawn is pinned. Rook a8 is hanging.
h6 is good. Bishop e3.
I'm very scared for that king on e4. One check and it's mated. Almost. Knight d5. Knight c3 is hanging. bd2. Knight.
But e5 is also hanging, Sagar. King e5.
Bishop e1.
Attacks the rook.
Yeah, I know.
D6.
I know.
Understanding why is...
I know. Super tension. We are down to 1 minute.
So many forks. They have to be super alert.
Amruta, just 1 minute for both sides. Vidit has only 45 seconds. No increment, guys. This is ultimate pressure. Knight a6 now. Can we take it? Take the pawn. Oh, king e3. He went back. Knight e4. Oh, he plundered. He plundered and Vidit is like very super quick and opens up. Now Vidit has to only manage his time. 38 seconds. Oh, what a blunder that was. Rook d7. Oh, he's...
Look, Sagar, finally it was a knight check. The knight...
I agree.
That's what I
agree.
2 seconds ago.
I know, Amruta. I know you are always right. But now, knight a5 is also hanging. I think Vidit is going through. He's going through. Rook a2 coming in.
This
king e6. Still Rook some Rook pressure A3. Because you have to win in 30 seconds, Amruta.
Rook A3, B4, just take care of pre-moves. Don't make any pre-moves. You have good enough time.
E4, wow.
Rook G4.
So clean, so clean. King C4.
Rook G1, no, not Rook G1. Rook H3 and Rook H1 meet.
Rook G1 up.
Would have been a disaster.
King is coming in with it. Gujarati going through to the semi-finals of the Dodgy Invitational. 2.0 is won it. 7 Ooh. Points.
Now, guys, one more time. 11,000 people with his OP. He has right now moved to semi-finals with 7 and 5 score.
Guys, thank you all for following this. What a great, great match by Vidit. We'll try to connect him here and bring him for at least a few seconds, because the way he's played is unbelievable. Also, would like to invite Anish. I don't know where Anish would be right now, because his match got over some time ago. But what a match this was. VDOP in the chat, guys. On that note, please like the stream if you enjoyed this commentary. We did not have the best resources because everything was kind of hanging, but
yeah,
on leeches, but it's fine. We enjoyed the match. I think the play quality was too good.
Very nice, very interesting how
he played. Also, great play by David Howell. Full credit to him. He was very close to enforcing Armageddon, Amruta. And guys, all the people who are watching this, please tune in tomorrow to Super Heroes Cup, which we are doing. You know, just come for some time. It's amazing. It's about 16. Differently abled chess players playing, top Indian players playing there, and today 8 of them won, so it's the quarterfinals tomorrow. Please do come. And meanwhile, we'll wait for if Anish or Vidit, someone can join in. What a match this was.
Yeah, I'm gonna tell Vidit, please guess Sagar's each and every question, and right now please start answering. Oh, yes. He asked for the link.
Yes. He's joining.
So, guys, he's joining. That's going to be amazing.
We are also called AG, but I don't know. Because AG's game got over a bit too soon, no? So, he might be busy right now.
When are the semifinals, Sagar? Are they tomorrow?
Huh?
are the semi-finals tomorrow?
Yeah, tomorrow.
Tomorrow, guys, semi-final.
Hello,
hi, Sagar bhai.
One second.
Hi, Amruta.
Hi.
क्या ही मैच था?
पागल जैसा था यार, complete. It was so crazy.
Yeah, it was like first two losses were like, you know, just like shook me up completely.
We had this our superheroes cup going on.
Yes, I saw.
So we were there, ठीक है, and then we got to know that when we started streaming, you were 3.5, 1.5 down at that point. So you were like, अरे बाप रे, and then you won a game. So it became 3.5, 2.5, and then so you got this nice flow, yeah. At some point where you started.
Yeah, I mean, I was a bit lucky on some occasions, without a doubt. Actually. After two losses, it felt like really tough already. Yeah, you're trailing down 2 points, and I felt like I was not warmed up. That's why I lost the first two games, like a bit too slow. And some games I was like really low on time. It was funny, but I'm very happy actually to cover and like, you know, after in the end also I created drama by losing that wide game.
वो pre-move था क्या? Was that a
pre-move? Pre-move, it was pre-move.
You thought King F4 था?
One second, we have to show that. And also your one game which is our favorite.
Exactly. Absolute, वो तो देखना ही
है. Absolute favorite. Bishop takes G6. ये वो.
Yeah, that
win. Sacrifice, ये दे दो, वो दे दो.
सब कुछ मारा था. I don't know what was going because, you know, we couldn't even watch the game on Lee Chess. We were watching it on... Chess 24, so the bar was not even helpful, so we had no idea what was going on, who was winning, nothing.
The good thing is we also didn't have any idea. I think only chat knows everything, you know, they had an idea what's happening.
One second.
But Vidit, how did you feel after that check, rugby at pre-move, and you lost immediately in the next game started?
One thing I felt good because it was funny that after one game, it was Nimzo Indian where I won. He had offered me a draw, David, and I declined and I won the game. And he got really pissed off after that game. So, so then I was like, okay. I won one game, but I think it was equal portion. I was slightly better. I had more active pieces. So I don't see the reason why I should accept a draw. Plus, I have like 30 to 40 seconds more. So I won that game. And then he wrote to me on direct message, you know. And then I was like, okay, fine. Take this game. Now
what
we are.
What did he say on message?
Well, he was angry. That's what I can say, you know.
I didn't know actually. You can offer a draw.
Yeah, you
can this event draw. You can offer draw, but you can talk to each other.
Yeah, direct message in Zoom, like, you know.
Acha, Zoom call.
So I was like, okay, fine. Now here it was drawn position, and now you won, so we are even. You know, now you can't blame me for. So in a way, that's good. In hindsight, of course, I would have loved to draw this game, but now I can say that.
Yeah, the thing is, you came here with why?
I thought King F4 he'll play, and
okay,
I played.
Okay, this is known as Lucina. Sorry, lead or position, third rank defense.
He would have flagged me here. I had low time. I had 17 seconds. He had 20 something seconds. So he would have definitely flagged me here. So that's why I started pre-moving. But yeah, okay.
Oh, but this was smart though, King F3.
Yeah. It was actually, I should have drawn this game earlier. I shouldn't have allowed the position to come here. Like, especially when I exchanged queens, wahapi kuch to like this position. Yeah, I should just instead of F3, maybe just take on F5 and, you know, just make a draw. Yeah,
you mean
Bishop E4 and Rook D1. Sorry,
here.
No. Instead of F3, Bishop E4 and Rook D1 also. Yeah, D5, Knight E4. And now I can play Rook D1, for example.
Acha, Rook D1.
And just Bishop E4 and exchange everything and draw, yeah?
True.
This actually, white is even better here.
Slightly so, better, yeah.
Yeah, I shouldn't have allowed that position to come. That was the problem.
And this game, Vidit, was unbelievable because, firstly, I mean, this was very nice. Here, you created something from nothing.
Yes. Black is slightly better. I mean, why should I accept draw here? You tell me.
No, definitely. I think it's not a draw, right? Because
here you always go try a little bit. So it was a very good decision to not take a draw.
Exactly. Why should I accept, bro? And then I don't think it was justified to get angry.
I agree with you completely.
Because here I'm just winning, yeah? So, I mean...
But he must have done it in some light humor or something, no?
I don't know. But it looked like he was angry because the message came immediately. But it's okay. I can understand in the motion, like, you know, emotion of the game. It happens.
Yeah.
So I was like, I felt a little bit bad about winning this game somewhere. Because
No, you can't feel bad.
But I don't understand. I think at no point it was very equal. It was always slightly...
Yeah, slightly better. Yeah.
Slightly
yeah.
better. And just this game, which was the epic attack.
Oh,
yeah.
This is our favorite game.
Yeah. So, okay, it was like in IQP structure, black got a very good position, I guess. Like everything was normal. And then
this
started.
Yeah, this was a little bit desperate. Like, you know, the A5 pawn is very weak. So I was like, okay, trying to desperately create something. And here he refused to repeat, which is makes sense because he has an extra pawn, yeah?
Ah, you were going to repeat, but...
Yeah, but what I can do? I'm pawn down, so I need to repeat.
True.
But he fought, and then he gave me this bishop c2, and then I don't know. I mean, I just played h4.
Yeah, this was so
makes
fun.
Sense. Makes
not
sense.
Not caring about b2 pawn here.
Yeah, there's bishop g6 always. That's why.
So you took here. Oh, but this rook a6 was necessary. Why couldn't you just take here?
fg6.
And then can you go queen?
I think max is perfect.
Queen g4. Queen e7. Queen g7. He has no.
Ah, right. And bishop g6.
Play for compensation like this. It's possible.
But risky.
Maybe, not sure.
I missed knight b4 idea, to be frank. That's why I thought for quite some time after knight b4 in the game. Rook a6, knight b4.
Oh, this knight b4 was very strong.
After knight b4, yeah. Bishop g6,
oh,
either
this was
calculation.
Cool. You know, Vidit, this is the best move in the position.
Yeah, I was forced to find
this
it because I have nothing
so
else.
And then take here. And now rook a7 perhaps, but okay. Queen g4, take. D, queen e7.
Yeah,
what a move again.
Yeah. Is it top move?
Yes, top move. Top move.
Yeah, I thought after rook d6, he has to play knight d5. That was the only move.
Yes, that is again the only move. Knight
and
d5.
Then I thought the point is knight d5, rook 1 d5.
Yeah.
And now we have e d5, rook g6. So that's lost.
Wow, this would be like number of another sack, na? He has sacked rook on a6, then rook d5, and then bishop g6. Three sacks. Wow.
But here he has knight d6. That's the thing.
And now if you take here...
Ed6, I have to take rook c1 check. That's the problem.
Oh,
and now
no.
I thought
king
d1
h2.
After.
Did you see all this?
Oh, yeah, I saw this. King h2, queen h7. That's the problem.
So
that's a rook. And I thought, okay, I can play this position, yeah? Because I have very strong pawn on d6.
Yeah.
Oh, this is slightly better for you with it.
Yeah.
What an assessment in
Brilliant.
5 minutes.
Great calculation. Great. And so he went queen f7. Rook d7 and yeah, this was just over. And again, this rook lift was very, very
accurate.
Mean,
this is, okay. I mean, this is just automatic. Yeah, this is nothing to think about. This is very like obvious. Yeah, this was a good game in a way.
I think in a way,
after
I
got
thought,
the chance, it was good.
I thought it was just like sack and would be lightly played, but all the moves were turning out to be now I'm checking best ones.
Hmm?
All our best moves by you. Almost.
Yeah.
Top choices of the engine.
Amazing. Yeah. No, this was a good game, yeah. But actually, like the initial games, I was like, did I mess it up, you know? I was kind of worried.
Yeah. No, great games with it. And also this IQP, I think you've played very well overall. Even this game was very messy.
Yeah, I thought, you know, queen a1. Oh, that's brilliant. Like queen g7. But there is rook is on the
side. That's what Sagar showed, guys. If you move your knight, queen g7 is a mate.
You know, I shouted, queen g7 mate. And then I was like, oh, rook.
But the thing is, you know, instead of knight b1, knight e2, I was thinking. But that doesn't work, luckily. Rook e2, queen e2, rook c6.
Ah, because the rook is overloaded here.
Yes. That's the thing.
And then if you take the rook, it's a mate here.
And then this position is much easier to play for white because his king is weak. Like, although I might be pawn down, his pieces are not coordinated, yeah? For one pawn and for blitz, I have very good position.
विदित डू यू वांट टू अर्न 5,000 रुपीज?
नहीं नहीं विदित
नो
अक्षय ना तो सर आई डोंट आई के सुपर चैट विदित कोट्स हाउ विल वर बट हिम बट
नो
अक्षय
नो
आई थिंक विदित मे बी वन मोर ही कैन डू क्राउड फंडिंग ऑन हिज स्ट्रीम एंड फॉर मे बी 50,000 दैट इज अ पॉसिबिलिटी.
अरे पर उसने कुछ किया ही नहीं, लाइक नथिंग हैपेंड. इट्स लाइक it's like you know in that game it's just like about flagging. Yeah, it felt like flagging, so it's understandable.
Can you come a little bit this side, you are going out of the frame.
Are sagar tumhe samajh mein nahi aa raha kya, black lotus is in the center.
No no, but
that's
it can be. Yeah, cool. But with it this was a great match here by you. In fact at the start I really again once again your opponents, even that day Peter Heine Nielsen played very well.
Yeah,
and
David today played like extremely good. Like that's why I said, I was a little bit lucky on some occasions. I feel like to first of all get back into the match, like three and a half ho gaya, and after that it was as a bit lucky. And also, for example, in must win game, he played. He put tension, with this love. So. And in the last game also I was lucky, for example.
Oh man, last game he played so well.
Exactly.
This
last
knight
game
g5 move.
The knights were moving just here and there. So my
this knight g5 move was so nice.
Yeah, like here, if we see, I thought that, okay, this is normal. But then this queen b4, queen exchange, and then slowly.
B5,
I loved when you played it, but then now I think it's not a great idea.
Really?
No, I don't know.
I still like it, actually.
I missed this
rook
a5 idea. Very strong move. Suddenly, there is pressure, It felt like, oh, wow, nice square. And, funny thing is, Sagar bhai, before the match, I saw your position, which you had sent to Samay, Vaibhav and Biswa, where you say, make square for the knight. And that there, the move is b5. Exactly. That's the move. There is pawn on c4. You play b5. You create a square for knight. Yeah. As influenced by you, Sagar bhai. This b5 move is because of you.
This is what happens when you are in bad company. You have to be. You have to be in the group with Magnus Carlsen, Caruana, and all of them. But yeah. So okay, that's how you came to this. Because here it seemed like if you get one move to coordinate somehow, but you are always one move short.
Look at this knight g5 move. That was so cool.
This is
knight
the best
G5, very nice move.
The idea is knight e4, knight c5.
Yeah, and then its position looked really worse. I thought Armageddon incoming.
Yes. We also were waiting for it. But then somehow he just blundered this exchange.
Yeah. Because the thing was, it was not easy. Mm-hmm. Like, it's better. We both know it's better for him. But it's not easy anymore.
Look at these two pieces, huh? They never moved till
now. Yeah.
38 moves. 38 moves. No, they didn't win.
Knight
went back to b8, Sagar. Knight hill ke wapas gaya.
Haan, but still.
When did the knight move? Knight never moved.
Knight b8 ka hila nahi kya?
Haan, ek baar hila, ek baar hila.
Yeah, it moved.
Once it moved.
It moved.
It was like, darwaza khol ke dekhta hun baar. Theek hai, ho gaya.
Yeah, and this in the end.
And but it often happens when you have two knights. Many times, like, you know that this is a blunder to avoid, but after a few moves, so much under pressure, it's somehow very common, right? This
true,
happens.
True. Yeah, okay. So, Vidit, who is your opponent now tomorrow? Winner of?
I think Jobawa versus who? Navara or who?
Jobawa Navara.
Yeah, I think Navara and they play tonight.
Yeah,
they're
playing. First game is drawn. Right now, they have started playing. So, very exciting. Maybe if Jobawa plays against you, you will face a very aggressive opponent. If Navara wins, you will face a very, how do you say, pragmatic opponent. So, it'll be fun tomorrow to watch this. Is it again at 7:30 tomorrow?
I don't know. I have to check.
Maybe
later.
The
timing I have no idea, actually. I have no idea.
So, Joy says, Akshanath got new debit and credit cards. Andadhun paisa hai, kar lo VD challenge except he might give 50k. Amit Kumar says, Sagar bhai, ask VD to clarify the Havel anger episode. Anger episode nahi tha, guys. It was
there
not
is
anger
no
episode.
Only
else, our desi chess trolls will rip him apart on all his social media.
I don't
videos.
Think so.
Yeah,
the
yeah,
simple
guys,
thing is, I played on in an equal position. And then the next game, I lost an equal position. So it's fine. Like, that's the episode. There's no episode. and he's one of the nicest guys in the circuit. Yeah, always smiling, very courteous, and you know, so there is really no need to have any issue at all. Absolutely.
Yeah. Yes. This absolutely. Was all in good humor, guys. So
yeah,
it's nothing bad. Also, we all know him is a very nice guy, and Vidit also. So
absolutely, absolutely.
Yeah, yeah.
Many please people. Anish also won very quickly. I think today he scored 6.5 points against Grandelius. 2.5 for him. So
match. He won so easily, yes. Two yeah. and six and half, two and half.
He won.
Actually, he lost one game towards the end, which
yeah. Which was a brutal attack by Nils. But apart from that, he was very clinical. And I think Anish is going strong. He will face the winner of Fresine and Dubov. So I think Dubov is heavy favorite.
Yeah, yeah.
So
Dubov is heavy favorite. Yeah. Dubov versus Anish could be an interesting match, actually. Ah,
very interesting. Dubov, Anish, and let's say.
And Blitz. Oh my God.
Vidit. Here it's difficult to choose between Jobava and Navarra, I think.
No, Jobava. He defeated Grishuk yesterday.
Yes.
Jobava is much more, like in Blitz, he's a better player.
But I think Jobava is very creative, but towards the end, many times he blunders in Blitz. Like he gets good positions, no?
No, no, he's strong. He's a strong player in Blitz. I don't think he blunders or something. Like yesterday against Grishuk, to defeat Grishuk is not easy. He played very good. I was watching that today, actually, the match. Achha. It seems like and he was dancing like while he danced and then defeated Grishuk. That was the funny thing. Like, did you see his video? Like, suddenly he goes like this, you know, he's like full.
No, I have not seen it. I'll see it.
He was streaming and he was dancing, so it was epic.
Amazing. You could also stream in this event, or is it like that? Like, you can
Switzler
stream
tried, but it, you know, I think it affects your concentration. Only like Hikaru and few people can do it, like maintain the same quality of play while streaming.
It is allowed to do this in this event.
Yeah, yeah. It's Swidler was doing commentary while you know, he was joined by Jan Gustafsson and Dodgy himself, and but it affected him. I think it got a bit slower because of that, and he lost to Fresine. Why is Anish not joined?
Anish today had to go for an interview in Dodgy channel. Chess24. So with Dodgy, he's giving the interview. So
he's not in chat, yeah?
No, he said he will come tomorrow after his game. So we will wait for him tomorrow. But Vidit, thanks for joining in. It was great fun. And maza aaya. Match dekh ke.
For sure.
Thank you.
Yeah. Take care.
Yes.
And relax a bit tomorrow. Do you prepare for these matches, or is it just...
Little bit. I saw his games and stuff, but like, I think it's so random. Whatever I prepared didn't come, so it's kind of useless. The preparation, you know.
Yeah, guys, with the VDOP in the chat, because today really it was heart throbbing. You know, these games were very very nervous for everyone. So great games, and it's always nice to end up in the winning side, because it's. Chess is such that the difference between winning and losing is often a move, so it can go either way. Today was a good day, and so all the best for tomorrow.
Thank you. Bye-bye.
Guys, that was Vidit Gujarati, who moves into the semi-finals with a powerful performance today, and he will take on the winner of Navarra versus Jobava. On the other hand, we have Anish Giri, who beat Grandelius, will take on the winner of Fresine Dubov. We've been streaming from 2 p.m. today. It's 9:43, 7 hours 43 minutes. And also before that, we are preparing a bit. So very tired. Thank you all for all the love, support. Please like the stream. And if you haven't subscribed to ChessBase India, please do so. I'll see you all tomorrow. 2:00. For the Superheroes Cup, and then at 7:30, I guess, for the Dodgy. We'll check the timings, but bye-bye.
Bye-bye.